This is Coding Math Mini number 10, More Random Distribution. Today we're going to look at some other quick ways to randomly distribute objects. Now say you wanted to randomly place a bunch of objects, particles, whatever, around the center of the screen so that they were no more than, say, 100 pixels from the center. You could write some code like this in main.js. This gets the center of the canvas using width divided by 2, and gets a random x by going 100 pixels to either side of it. Then it does the same thing on the y-axis, and then draws a small dot there. If you do this 1,000 times, you'll get something that looks like this. Now this might not be exactly what you expected, or at least not what you wanted. But by defining min and max x and y's, you've basically formed a rectangle. Maybe you wanted something more round, like an explosion. In that case, what you need to do is define a circle. A circle is defined by a radius that goes around 360 degrees, or 2 pi radians. To get a random point within a circle, you need a random angle from 0 to 2 pi, and a random radius from 0 to the overall radius of the circle. Well, that's easy enough. We can define a max radius, and then use random range to get an angle from 0 to 2 pi, and a radius from 0 to max radius. Then we use the cosine of the angle times that radius to get an x, and the sine of that angle times the radius for y, and draw the dot there. And what does this give us? Much better. Now, if you wanted to distribute the objects in a random ellipse rather than a circle, you could just define a max x radius and a max y radius. Then you get random values based on each of those. And use them to get the x and y. And that gives you something like this. Now, going back to the circle for a moment, you'll notice that the dots here seem to be clumped towards the center of the circle. You might think there's something wrong with our random function, that it's biasing its results towards the center, but it's not. You're giving it an equal chance of creating a small radius as you are a chance of creating a near maximum radius. So roughly half the particles will be nearer to the center of the circle, and half will be more towards the outer edge. But the center of the circle has much less area than the outer edge, so you have the same amount of particles crammed into a smaller space. Here I've placed 10 dots at a small radius and 10 at a larger radius. But the dots in the center look very cramped, and the ones at the outer edge are spaced out much further. Now there's a cool trick if you want to evenly distribute objects across a circle. We've been using random range to get the radius, but because minimum is 0 and maximum is max radius, this is equivalent to saying math random times max radius. If we change that to take the square root of the random number, like so, and then multiply it by max radius, this biases the resulting random numbers toward the higher end of the range. So you'll get fewer particles closer in and more further out. That bias is just enough to make them appear evenly spaced. Now, going back to rectangular versus circular distribution, there's another application of this that might not be so obvious. So you're making an explosion of particles. You place them all at one point and give them random velocities and let them do their thing. The file main2.js demonstrates this. Here, I've set the random velocity using random values for vx and vy. And I've kept them rather low so you can see what's happening. Let's take a look. As you can see, when the particles expand outward, they're doing so in a rectangular spread. You may not notice this if you have fewer particles or if they're moving rather quickly, but here it's pretty obvious. The solution is to randomly set the angle and magnitude of the velocity vector rather than the x and y component velocities. This is equivalent to setting the angle and radius in the earlier examples. It's just applied to motion instead of position. We can do this using setSpeed and setHeading. So, after we make those changes, we retest it, and we have a much more realistic explosion. So this is just a quick one today, but I think you'll find it useful. I know I find myself using this one all the time.